Benson doing it pretty well. And he's followed along by Michael Taylor. Then we go back to Greg North. Then we go back a bit further to Peg and McAdee. David Bray is there. Then it's Charlie Walsh. Steel Bishop takes over the role. Swim followed by Laurie Venn. Danny Clark up around the outside. Then it's Dennis Clark moving along the back straight. He's followed around the outside by Craig Price. Ron Grinder on the tail of the field. Then we go back to Murray Hall. Down the back straight they go. And into the bottom bend. It looks to me as though it could be Michael Taylor out in front. Then we go back a little bit further to Greg North. Then up on the outside it could be David Benson. Steel Bishop moves around the outside, followed by Laurie Venn. And then we go back to Danny Clark, a long, long way back to Craig Price. A huge crowd roars and the faces are cracking in the final of the Brownie World. 20,000 people roar their approval now as we see Laurie Venn take off down the back straight. He's got Craig Price in tow. Danny Clark down a little bit on the outside. Then we go back a little bit to Greg North, the big Christmas flag, and Steel Bishop around the outside. Danny Clark goes blocked off a little bit. Then they go to the bottom fellow with Laurie Venn out in front, followed by Danny Clark. Danny Clark moves up around the outside. He moves up on the outside of it, and he's got a win the Brownie World race. Danny Clark wins the Brownie World race, and Steel Bishop in the third place would have been Laurie Venn. He came home all the way from Europe to win the Brownie World race, and he did that. Danny Clark has won the 1979 Brownie World race from Steel Bishop.